Our weather pattern is about to produce a very powerful storm, everybody. This is bringing chances for damage and winds, hail, including tornadoes, also the freezing temperatures and very cold wind chills right behind it, and bring a potential major snowstorm as it builds for this weekend. Now, we have a little bit more clarity of what's going to happen as we got a little bit closer now. So for tomorrow, we do have the chances for damage and winds and hail. As we go into Thursday, this is going to build. Chances for tornadoes, hail, as well as damage and winds. But Thursday evening, I'm showing the damage and winds could go a little further towards Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes. Then we still have our main event for Friday, where we could have a lot more tornadoes, damage and winds, and hail again. So I'm going to show you the latest information in this video, what is right around a corner on our weather pattern, everybody. Happy Tuesday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. I have some new information for you, so I'm gonna go right into the forecast. So for tomorrow, for Wednesday, you can have thunderstorms in any of these two green areas. There's no chances for tornadoes. There's gonna be chances for wind and hail. So here's your cities and states at risk for chances for hail threats for tomorrow, for Wednesday. And here's your cities and states at risk for the damage and winds. So for today, you can see thunderstorms over here along Washington, Oregon, even snow in higher elevations. But this is where we also get into storms across the Northeast, bringing freezing rain, bringing sleet, and bringing snow for New England all the way until tomorrow morning. Now, as we go into tomorrow, this is where this cutoff low is coming from the southwest, bringing some severe weather with it as it goes across the four corners for Wednesday evening into the south central all the way till Thursday morning. So there will be some storms as you go through for Wednesday evening, but it will be more severe as you go into Thursday, bringing chances for damage and winds and hail, and you cannot rule out a brief tornado. Now, when you go through Thursday night, you can see that it starts going towards Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes, bringing a threat as well. So far, I'm showing chances for hail and damage and winds. Then we have what kicks off for Friday. This is where we get that negative tilt. We get a deep trough, and we get a number of storms building up. So for Thursday, you can see thunderstorms over here along Arizona, a little bit of Nevada, also in this whole green area going from the south central all the way towards the Great Lakes. Now, we do have our severe weather. We do have a 5%, and this is for all hazards, chances for damage and winds, hail, and tornadoes. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather for Thursday. And you can see here by National Weather Service, if the storms can mature within a favorable sheared environment, then the threat for damage and winds, isolated hail, and a tornado could evolve, everybody. I still think this could linger all the way towards Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes, at least for chances of damage and winds, some high winds coming through. Then as we go into Friday, then our main event, as we get that negative tilt on that shortwave trough and starts bringing chances for tornadoes, damage and winds, and hail again. So far, here's cities and states at risk for the severe weather for Friday. Now, you see for Thursday with National Weather Service on your severe weather, you can also see here on Colorado State University, still showing it could be upgraded a little bit more over here for eastern Oklahoma, Arkansas, southern Missouri, southern Illinois, and western Tennessee. Then as we go into Friday, we have our main event where it's going to be stronger. And you see here with Colorado State University showing it could be more intense for Louisiana going through central and northern Mississippi. And still showing as we go through Saturday, it could go a little bit further towards the northeast, bringing at least a marginal threat. This would be for damage and winds and possibly small hail. So if you take a look here, you can see it in our vorticity that we have our little cutoff low over there for tomorrow, coming across the four corners for Wednesday evening, across the south central, bringing that threat all the way till Thursday, going all the way towards Ohio Valley. But our main threat is going to come from this deep trough right behind it, as it literally goes into that negative tilt and starts intensifying the storms over here across the south. This will make for strong storms going for Friday evening all the way to Friday night, coming across for the northeast. We do have a low pocket of instability that comes across as well. Now, if you take a look at your weather pattern, you see we have this big upper level high over here going clockwise, revolving all this moisture into that direction. Why are you getting this cold trough of cold air coming down and pivoting right towards the same area? So this section right here where the warm air and the cold air is still going to meet together is still going to be our most hostile area. Still showing us bringing damage and winds and that big snowstorm all the way towards the Great Lakes and the Northeast as you go through for Saturday as well, showing the winds do pick up. When you have low pressure and high pressure squeezing together, you get right here, these tight isobars. And that signifies a lot of chances for high winds and strong wind chills. Now, as we go into Thursday, this is where it really builds. Thursday and Friday, could we sit right in that deep trough and just continuously bringing all this warm temperatures and moisture right across the lower Mississippi and mid-Mississippi Valley, bringing a lot of instability all the way from Thursday and into Friday, where it gets stronger for Friday. Then for Saturday, you can see that little poof of instability that goes towards the Northeast. This will bring some thunderstorms with it as well. And the whole time while you're getting these thunderstorms, this is where that cold air is coming through, bringing that snowfall for Friday going into Saturday. Then the cold blast comes right through all the way till Sunday and Monday after that. This is a 6Z with the Euro. This come out this morning. Still showing as we go through for Thursday, we have some strong winds aloft. This will continue your thunderstorms all the way towards Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes as you go through Thursday evening. This is going to bring a potential damage and wind event for y'all. Then as you go overnight Thursday into Friday, we're going to get more strong winds aloft as we get that negative tilt, bringing our threat all over again. And this is going to bring the strong wind chills still. Now, if you notice, it has shifted a little bit further towards the east, but I'm still showing the impacts are the same. And you can see that trough coming down, bringing the chances for damage and winds with this weather pattern. Showing damage and winds for today, also for tomorrow, where it really builds up as we go Thursday into Thursday evening, all the way from the South Central all the way towards the Great Lakes, bringing that 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gusts all the way towards the interior Northeast. Now, when a deep trough comes, it's still bringing all the very cold temperatures with it. That's going to bring this snowstorm, and it's going to help the snow stick around for the weekend. And you see it really digs in as we go from Friday all the way from the South Central towards the Great Lakes, all the way towards Saturday for the mid-Mississippi Ohio Valley, all the way through Sunday for the Northeast. And still bringing major snow all the way for today and tomorrow for the Rockies and the Cascades. But as we go all the way for Friday into Saturday, this was bringing that major snowstorm. Now, once again, this is the 6Z. This is the newest run this morning with the European. And you can see the latest projections on that snowstorm, showing the same thing with GFS. GFS has finally come around to what the Euro has been saying all along. So as we check for the possibilities of what actually could be the outcome, we go to the ensembles. Each one has a little bit different variations, so we can see what the possibilities are from the worst case scenario to the best case. And you can see a lot of these showing this strong storm all the way from the Four Corners, all the way from the Central Great Plains, all the way towards the Great Lakes. There's still a few that show it could meet a timing of a warm scenario where it won't get that snowfall for the Central Plains and it'll only be around the Great Lakes. But showing more than likely than not, you will get something there. It just won't be the major snowfall. Showing the major snowfall will be as it goes into the evening towards the Great Lakes and for the Ohio Valley. You can see this on the other 25 ensembles. Showing a little bit warmer scenario is a good possibility, but once again, it's going to be about timing. And you can see with the GFS ensembles as well, there's 30 on the GFS, showing it's still a 50-50, everybody, whether the snowstorm is going to be big or whether it's going to be small. But you can see you're going to get something according to a lot of these ensembles along the Central Plains, just not a lot. And you can see here on the latest forecast by the European that as we go into Thursday morning, this is where you're more likely going to start getting thunderstorms as we get that surface low built over here for Kansas. And this is going to bring chances for damaging winds, maybe even a brief tornado they need to be aware of. And as we go towards lunchtime, it moves towards Missouri, southern Iowa, into Illinois, where it stays close towards that surface low. We might get cyclogenesis. We might get a strengthening low pressure. Well, this will bring some damaging winds for Thursday evening for Illinois, Indiana, maybe southern Michigan, and western Ohio. As we go into Friday, this is where we get that deeper trough building up. And this is where we really start getting a threat for tornadoes as we get some supercells forming as we go through Friday around lunchtime. It really builds up multiple layers of storms, bringing damaging winds and some supercells potential tornadoes, everybody. Now, as you go through Friday evening, it really deepens and we get that surface low right there where it's more of a threat all the way until Friday evening for the south. This is where the cold temperatures are coming down towards the four corners and the snow is starting to build up. Remember, this is a low pressure going clockwise, spinning all that precipitation towards those colder temperatures. So as we go into Friday evening, you're going to see more snow. You're going to see more storms over here from the mid-Mississippi, lower Mississippi Valley, all the way until Saturday, where we still have a surface low over here towards Ohio Valley, and we could be another day of severe weather. Now, our instability is over here towards the south, but we still have that little pocket that goes towards the northeast that could bring more of a threat. Maybe some hail, maybe some damaging winds on a linear event. Got to get a little bit closer. We are literally going right past 4 days at this point. We're getting that cold air, getting that snowstorm, and getting more storms as we go through for Saturday evening as well. Now, the temperatures you can expect as we go through Saturday morning, we get in that deep trough, bringing the freezing temperatures and bringing the very strong wind chills. Showing possibly in Colorado, you could feel maybe negative 20 to negative 30 degree wind chills as that comes through. And you see here with GFS, it is agreeing with the European. Comes down again for Saturday over here towards Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes, bringing the strong wind chills with it. And you can see with GFS also in agreement, a little bit deeper though. Sunday, it stretches towards the interior northeast, bringing the freezing temperatures, bringing the very cold wind chills. And you can see with GFS also agreeing with the Euro. And Monday, it's really going to pivot towards the eastern U.S. while the western U.S. is in frozen as well. And with the wind chills coming in for Monday, this is where the deepest pitch could go all the way towards the southeast. You can also see with the GFS also in agreement. So we have a little bit more information of what is possibly happening right around the corner, everybody. I will keep you updated. When we start tomorrow off, we'll have better information. Then I will start afternoon updates as well. That way we can get it narrowed down to a timing and impacts and what you can expect. This is going to be dangerous for some of your travels, everybody. Now remember, we still have that freezing rain that's coming down possibly for today into tomorrow over here across Minnesota, Wisconsin, and Michigan. And for the Northeast, you get a chance for some freezing rain and then some snow. Just be aware that. But as we go into Thursday all the way into the weekend, everything's going to start getting a little more intense. But thank you again for your time. Hope you have a very blessed day out there, everybody. Thank you again for your support, all the likes and shares. I do see them. Thank you so much. I really do appreciate you for it. And before I go, a quick word from our Father, everybody. James 1:17-20. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath, for the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. Amen. Thank you for your time, everybody. Make sure you're paying attention to the weather forecast. That way you know what to expect right around the corner from the storm system. Also, this weather pattern. Not everybody's going to be in the storms, but they are going to be in these cold temperatures and very cold wind chills. I will see you again for tomorrow morning. And remember, above all things, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody.